Hi, good afternoon. Let us start our fifth module, that is Indian Economic Thought. In the earlier modules, we studied Islamic Economic Thought, then Classical Economic Thought, Keynesian Economic Thought, Marginalist Ideas, etc. In this chapter, we have to discuss about Indian economic ideas. First, we have to learn about early economic ideas, that is Kaudilya. We heard several times about Kaudilya. Kaudilya was Prime Minister of Chandragupta Maurya. Kaudilya was Prime Minister of Chandragupta Maurya. Chandragupta Maurya was a ruler at the Chola dynasty. It is as a part of the Tamil Nadu also. He was known as Chanakya or Indian Machiavelli. Kaudilya also known as Chanakya or Indian Machiavelli. His book Arthashastra gives details of political, social, economic and military concepts. His famous book Arthashastra, Artha means wealth. Arthashastra gives details of political, social, economic and military concepts. Then we can check his major ideas. First, wealth. Artha. Acquisition of wealth was described as one of the four major goals of life. You know, every human being are trying to acquire wealth. That is one of the major goal of his life. Then he discussed dharma, artha, kama and moksha also. Dharma means dharma, artha wealth, kama means act, moksha means spiritual manner, religious spirituality. Then vartha, next concept is vartha. Vartha means science of national economy. Vartha means science of economy of a country. He included agriculture, animal husbandry and trade as major activities, good activities. Then labor and caste. Next, third concept is agriculture. He gave more importance to agriculture. He gave more importance to agriculture. Then next concept, labor and caste. In ancient India, caste system prevailed. In ancient India, that we know, we studied in the history, casteism was very bad situation in our country. He gave importance to each labor discipline. In ancient India, caste system prevailed, but he gave more importance to every laborers are equal. Then value and trade. Value of each commodity according to time and place. He considered value of a commodity according to time and place. No value for items incapable of exchange. Suppose if any commodity is with us but it cannot exchange, such product, such commodity has no value. So value of every commodity is depends upon its time and place. He gave more importance to the problems of trade also. He gave more importance to the problems of trade also. Next concept, public finance. Land revenue was an important source of taxation. Land revenue, that is tax collecting from land. is also important source of taxation. Arthashastra elaborate scheme of public finance. Through his book Arthashastra, he discussed the very detailed manner regarding public finance. Tax collected as per quality of land. That was we studied the Ricardian theory of rent. That was also as per the quality of land. Then he recommended balanced budget. Balanced budget means revenue equal to expenditure. Then he classified tax receipt into three. He classified tax receipt into three. Tax on goods produced within the country. Tax on goods produced within the country. If any goods are producing in our country, tax will impose. Then goods produced in the capital. Then income earned through export, import and other tax. Then main items of public expenditure are national defense, administration, slavery, army, etc. The main purpose, main items spent for public expenditure are for national defense, for administration purpose, slavery, army, etc. They gave much importance to welfare. So, Kaudilya gave more importance to the welfare of the country. The major economic ideas of Kaudilya, he was the prime minister of Chandragupta Maurya. He was known as Chanakya. His famous book is Arthashastra. It gives details of politics, social, economic and military concept. His ideas are wealth, vartha, agriculture, labor and caste, value and trade, public finance and different types of tax also discussed. Next economist is Thiruvalluvar. That term is very familiar to you. He belongs to Sangam age. His famous book is Thirukkural. This Thirukkural has various parts. His economic ideas found in the second part of the Thirukkural. His economic ideas found in the second part of the Thirukkural. Porathupal is the part dealing with wealth. His Thirukkural has different parts. Then major economic ideas consist in the part of Thirukkural. Second part of the Thirukkural, Porathupal is the part dealing with the wealth. He gave importance to agriculture. Agriculture mainly depends upon rain, and at that time likewise. His ideas are poverty and begging. He condemned poverty and begging as great curses of the society. He is not liked poverty and begging. He considered it is a curse, shapam of the society. Then wealth explained the importance of accumulation of wealth and regarded wealth as only means, not an end. According to him, industry is the real wealth and labor is the great resource. So he explained the importance of accumulation of wealth and he regarded wealth as the only means, not an end. According to him, industry is the real wealth and labor is the great resource. Then agriculture. Most fundamental economic activity is considered as the agriculture. It is superior to all occupation. And next idea is public finance. Main source of revenue are wealth. Wealth comes by itself. Then customs. He discussed also customs. Tribute paid by defeated enemies. Defeated enemies means failed. Then payment of land revenue became part of normal duty of every citizen. He should pay land tax to the government. That is a duty of citizen. That is his concept. Then public expenditure. spending, government should spend for defense, social service, public work, and then give importance to welfare state, education as an important factor that promoted economic progress. That you know, he gave more importance to the development of education. Education as a most important factor and promote economic progress. Then external assistance. He was against dependence on external assistance. He recommended self-sufficient economy. Dependence on external assistance means we should not expect help from other countries. We should self-sufficient. Our country should be a sufficient, self-sufficient economy. So these are the major ideas of Thirukkural. Thiruvalluvar, may most important book is Thirukkural. It has different parts. In the second part, he explained regarding economic ideas. He gave more importance to agriculture, education, public finance, public expenditure, etc. Then next, modern economic ideas. Among these, we have to learn different economists. First, we have to learn about Dadabhai Navroji. That also you familiar to you. In the history class, you have studied. He lived during 1825 to 1917. Born in Bombay, known as Grand Old Man of India. Dadabhai Navroji, known as Grand Old Man of India. Then father of Indian nationalism, is considered as the father of Indian nationalism. His famous book is Poverty and Un-British Rule in India. He concentrated on poverty. He conducted survey of per capita income in Bombay for year 1867 to 1870. Among the modern Indian economists, he conducted first survey regarding per capita income during the period of 1867 to 1870. Then another theory of Dadabhai Navroji is drain theory. Dadabhai Navroji is famous as an economist for drain theory. He states that the consequence of foreign domination was the drain of wealth of India to England, and the high cost of British administration has disastrous effect on Indian economy. That now we know, before Indian independence, they are ruled by British Empire. At that time, they looted, they exploited our resources, everything they exploited. Thereby, our Indian wealth is flowing to Europe, England. And we are spending more money for the British administration also. That is a very disastrous effect on the Indian economy. The drain was one of the main cause of poverty of India. This drain of the wealth to other European countries are the major cause of the poverty of India. The drain of wealth took place in number of ways. Large remittances were made by European officials of their savings in India. Large remittances were made by European officials of their savings in India. It is one of the reasons for drain of our wealth to England. Then, large remittances were made in the form of salary and pension. We have to pay very high salary and pension for European officials. Then, India often had to pay for government expenditure in England and India. At that time, India is bearing the expenditure for both India and England also. That is a very sad matter. Then non-official Europeans made remittances from their business profit in India. Non-officials also came to India and they tried to loot India and exploited India. They take profit from India to their country. Navroji studied this theory by collecting lot of statistical data regarding export, import, salary of British staff, railway construction and expense of Indians. Benefit of railway construction were enjoyed by foreigners, but its burden borne by Indians. Actually, Europeans constructed railway in India, but its benefit only for them, not for Indians. But its expense fully borne by Indians only. Europeans exploited Indians by different ways. India and England should pay all salaries to their people within their boundaries. Then an Englishman were paid reasonable salary while they served in India. There was no need to pay pension to them. If any Europeans worked here, we give salary, but we also suffering the problem of their pensions also. All advantages from Indian Navy went to England. All advantages from Indian Navy also goes to England. India should not charge any portion of expenditure for maintenance of Navy. Oh. In conclude, Navarroji studied the drain theory by collecting statistical data. He states our Indian wealth only goes to England only. That was the major reason for the poverty. Okay, we can wind up today's session. Thank you.